My name is Mac Van Dam. I am the co-founder of NUNA Studio, and we are developing kind of contemporary bio-based living wall systems for urban buildings to bring back biodiversity in a way that's sustainable. Biodiversity right now is really forefront of people's minds. So that's causing a lot of momentum around this. This project is a installation done with Grosvenor Estates in London, and it's a demonstration of our product acting as a kind of like a rain garden or sustainable urban drainage system. We needed to find a way to create a kind of watertight seal between the four inlets that branch out in quite a complex geometry. Generally, making kind of complex, small plastic parts, I would use a 3D printer. We found we weren't able to get the water resilience and the moisture resilience that we needed with kind of typical 3D printing materials. Because we're a small company and every project kind of is unique, we're continuously going through product development. We don't have the budget in these projects to invest in kind of tooling. I believe that pressure forming is a really great manufacturing technique where you kind of take a sheet material and you are able to turn it into a three-dimensional object with kind of little energy input. I really appreciate it, and it's a good one to learn as a designer, I think. We have these very intentional inserts that we made with the Meku multiplier. We needed kind of very specific materials, and we wanted to use really kind of thin plastic materials again to kind of minimize the amount of plastic. One of the things that we were doing is testing the limits a bit with the machine in terms of the kind of max depth along with the kind of complexity of the shape. We needed kind of really fine detailing in the kind of corners and the crevices of a part that's actually fairly complex and detailed. One of the things that we did was we really had to optimize the parameters of the molding process so that we could press the part and get that detail, because we were using kind of low-cost 3D printed molds. We wanted to mold multiple parts per press, so that required an additional level of calibration and kind of temperature gauging. The main benefit was we could create something in a moisture resilient material without investing heavily into expensive molds, and knowing that we're free to kind of change the design the next time in a kind of affordable and thoughtful way. Our philosophy is a kind of like biomaterial revolution is actually a hybridized relationship with concrete, metal, plastic. We are more intentional about the materials towards the goal of reducing embodied carbon, reducing kind of environmental impact of the material choices.